So, last time, when we did some Dialtown, we might have ended off on a weird note because the game crashed. That was great. I don't know how I crashed a visual fucking novel, but it's okay, because I basically played up to pretty much back to where we crashed, at least the scene anyways, because I was not expecting the game to crash, so I hadn't saved in a while. But it should be good now. Okay. So I played all the way back to right whenever we, I didn't read that fully. It said Randy's good ending, and then in parentheses it said really quickly, pre-swan encounter. What are we going to see? Oh, dear Lord. Okay, well... Yes, scene starts, and Randy now took over Ticket Jerry's position, and we're gonna see where that gets him. Here we are, my new post. Let me tell you, it feels really nice. Wow. Been a bit since, had anyone, do that. No, fuck you. Yeah, there we go. So crash the game again. We'll see. If that happens or not. Tell you, it feels really nice knowing that if any swans appear within near striking range of me, that I'll have my coward glass to protect me. And the only way in is through a locked door on the side of the hut. You don't think a swan could learn how to work a door handle, do you? Well, if a velociraptor can, best lock the door from the inside just in case. Oh, hey, you know what the best part about all this is? Yeah, Apparently, the boss says I get to sleep on the floor of the hut because that way I'll have to listen out for noises at night because of my general sleep anxiety, and he doesn't have to pay me for working the night shift since I'm just using my herbivore survival mechanic. I tried to do the whole thing at one breath, but yeah. At my place of work, off duty. It's a win-win. Symbiotic exploitation. So, it looks as if you've got some place to sleep then. But out of curiosity, if you work at the fun for now, does that mean you have the keys to enter at will? Oh, sure, I've returned to the site of my accident. Mostly just to throw the Madam Mediocre machine in the dumpster. Oh, to prevent future lawsuits. Actually, I just don't think I could sleep in the booth with the thing outside. So I just tossed the thing out. Wait a moment. I passed the fairground dumpster on the way in here. There was nary a madame in there. Oh, pfft, not our dumpster. Don't you worry, I found just the other, now empty, dumpster for her. Who left this? Who left this thing in my dumpster? Randy, did you do this? Tee, the mouse that ate the cheese. Okay, no idea what that means, but heck yeah, justice. Oh, man, the memories. Hey, I even found the hot dog I got for you during our date. The one I dropped after witnessing you laying your egg clutch, you know. Can I have that? Can I have the hot dog? I mean, you know, it's been on the ground for at least 48 hours, right? Oh, please, I've eaten weeks old roadkill, so cough up. Oh, fuck, it's a swan. Hey, it's a swan. Jeffrey, I've seen enough dinosaur movies to know. These things are the descendants of T-Rexes, so if you don't move, it can't see you. And you're sweating heavily. $10 says it can smell you through the glass. Shit. I don't know, man. Looks fairly docile to me. Why don't you feed the old hot dog that you found on the ground? Make love, not war. Worst case scenario, it'll reject your booth dog and just waddle off. Well, I guess I can... What was that sound it made? Well, that was horrific. Yeah, it was. Huh. I guess the swans of the park were just... hungry? Who would have thought that? I mean, they were trying to eat you. Yeah, but I figured it was like a maliciousness thing. I've never heard of anyone trying to maliciously devour someone else. Hey, Donut. Trust me, man. Creatures tend to eat for nourishment, sport, or sexual gratification. No. Are you sure you don't wanna? Sure you don't wanna? Wait, did you just say sexual gratification? Dearest Randall, you're far happier not knowing. Dearest Randall. Donut, I definitely see how you get a lot of your speech patterns. Right. Oh, bye, swan. Okay. So your whole hobo shtick is done, then? Alright, no. Happy for you, Shug. I'm sure Jerry is, too. Thanks, and... wait. So if I'm here, then, where did Jerry end up? Is he okay? Don't worry, Randy. I made sure that he's been well taken care of. What does that mean exactly? Nothing. I just don't think Jerry's gonna be bothering us anymore. Why does that sound so ominous? Jeffrey, where's Jerry? Somewhere we won't be seeing much of him anymore, winky face. Somewhere far more peaceful. Well, specifically? Oh my god. What? Why was he in a wheelchair? Why is... Okay. He is now Shepherd Jerry in a wheelchair. Was he always crippled? I guess we can never tell because he was behind the booth, but was he always in a wheelchair? He's a shepherd now. And the sheep... the sheep had yarn balls for heads. I think... You know... There's a... There's a thing in writing called show, don't tell. And to be honest, I think this game does that extremely well, sometimes at least. Just showing us, instead of telling us, just enhances the experience so much more, and I'm so glad about it. If anything, he was overqualified for the position. Wait, why'd you give him that job and me this one? Why not just cut out the middleman and give the shepherd job to me? Oh, please, you on a farm? I don't understand, Randy. Horses bite, Randy. Okay, yep, understood now. And let's not forget Turkey, the tasty and angry cousin of swankind. Not wrong. Mom, come pick me up upstairs. Well, with Madame getting thrown out, Bunny getting fucking flattened, my poverty being cured, and my curse being revoked, I guess that means each and every loose end has been nearly tied up. Nobody move! Nobody fucking move! Ah, darn it. Interesting tale. Consequences. I hate those. That's right, you bandit schmuck. I told you that I'd track you down for not getting me off. How'd you even find me anyway? How'd you think, bozo? I searched every public place in this dumpster fire of a city. Every shop, every park, every gazebo. Every gazebo? Each and every one. This is literally the last public place in the city that I hadn't checked. I told you that I'd find yous. Wait. Were you pantsless during the whole search? He is very pathetic. Did you literally walk around the entire city of Dialtown without any pants on? Yeah, you bet I did, Nimrod. Some paper-pushing printer bitch called the fuzz on me for violating the bank's dress code. Hey, don't you fucking talk about Karen like that. Sorry, I'm getting a little excited. Alright, now this guy like fucking deserves to die for calling Karen a fucking paper-pushing printer bitch. Fuck you. She's much more than that. Karen is much more than that. No shirt, no pants, no service. Bullshit. That's... My god, you really are the most pathetic person in Dialtown, aren't you? Not anymore! I've got one bullet, and by phone god am I gonna use it! That sounds like a great plan, except... The glass is bulletproof, you know? Ah, shit, really? Bulletproof, huh? Jeez, for a place with rides that kill people every year, you guys really go all out on employee safety, don't you? Yeah, my new job has its perks. Ah, well, don't you worry, it's all G. I'll just shoot what's his face instead. Oh my god, Jerry. Oh, Randy, I mean. Randy's fucking going. What is he doing? Wait, he can't do that. I mean... I totally can, bozo, since I've actually got a bullet this time. Please, you can't. Randy, shh, don't beg. It's okay. I've had a good life. I've made peace with my demons. What? Are we getting a flashback of our life? Okay, I don't believe any of that actually happened. Oh shit, you're right. My life was horseshit. Ah, to hell with it, Mugger Guy. Just do your thing. Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this. Is that a swan? Ah, shit. What's this fucking thing doing so far from the park? Swan, attack! Oh my god! Why did that even work? You fed it a stale hot dog, Randy. You're a dad now, like it or not. Hey, Donut, I got a stale hot dog if you want it. Huh. I guess swans can seem kind of cute when they're not trying to pierce my jugular. Hey, before we wrap up, can you come outside for just a moment? From behind my beloved Pyrex force field? I have something to give to you. Can you slip it through the slot? Just come out smelly. Alright, alright. So, what is it? Well, I found something else in the dumpster. The same one I found the candles in the dumpster meat in. Huh. Huh. Okay, I was gonna sneeze and went away. Candles, dumpster meat, and something else valuable enough to give to your boyfriend as a gift? My, what a bountiful dumpster! What is it anyways? Let me show you. Is that a... Band-Aid? For Randy? I don't understand. My biggest wound, my pride, it's been fixed, right? What could you possibly- Your forehead, you cretin! This Band-Aid could go over your bandage. Oh, I see. That's the nicest thing anyone's ever done for me. Thank you. Just need to make one little adjustment. Oh god, you're writing something on the bandage. What are you gonna write? Ooh. We have a route diverging choice here. Post a mugger encounter. Oh wow, we can try a few different things here. Something soul destroyingly mean. Why would you ever do that? Something cutesy, something encouraging. Let me just. I did save. Okay. Something cutesy. Oh, hold on, let me quickly check my reflection in this puddle. It says sweetheart. Sweetheart? Oh, I don't know about... You really think I'm a... You know it, babe. Jeffrey, thank you for believing in me. Eggs! Well, someone had to, Randy. And I'm so glad it was you. Aww. Yay! The ending where things work out just fine for our dear friend, Randall Jade. Yay! We were that close to finishing it, and the game crashed. But it's okay, because we're going to continue to do more with the next route. It's, I mean, might as well. Just why not? Because I want to. Let's also quickly see what happens if we write something encouraging. What is it we write? I don't want to. I actually kind of don't want to see what it is if we write something mean spirited, because that's just fucking rude. Tough guy. Wait. tough guy. Are you... You're not making fun of me, are you? What? No! But I'm not a... Oh, please. You think any scallywags, ne'er-do-wells, or hooligans are gonna mess with a bandage-certified tough guy? Bandages don't usually just say things, you know? I know you can prove the bandage right, Randy. I believe in you, smiley face. I... Thank you, Jeffrey. For everything. Yeah. Honestly? I don't know if that was my favorite route or not. That was really good, but I guess we'll see. Because we still technically have two more routes to go. We have one more, and then we unlock a chapter two. So I don't know. Now crush his soul. I don't want to do that! That's so mean! I don't want to do that. But fine. We'll see. God. That's so fucking mean, man. I don't want to... Dude, Mance has been through enough. I don't want to fucking... I feel bad. Fuckface V2. Oh my god. Can't believe you... Raise me up just to throw me back down the ground at terminal velocity, shattering me into million bite-sized pieces. Get over it. And lifting me up, you just gave me further to fall. Oh god, my heart, why? Kind of inside man. I don't understand. Never about love, Randy. Life is merely a game of chess. Egg chess! Now that you're in there, I'm no longer at the mercy of strong-willed Ticket Jerry. But instead, weak-willed Ticket Randy. Oh my god. You're cowardly. Malleable. This time, oh my god. I do lay eggs, yes. Let me in. Do you have $2, sir? Both know that I don't. We also both know that you lack the will to stop me entering. Taking all that you had left. Goodbye. Jesus Christ. Something? Sure, lie. Jesus, I hated that. Oh my god. Yeah, anyway, you break Randy's heart for no real reason. Yeah, that was fucking horrible. Jesus Christ. Well, let's... Be nice! Oh, chapter 3, that's what it is. Let's be nice to someone and not crush their fucking soul. Jesus Christ, that was awful. Alright. Well, what do we name ourselves? What should we name ourselves? Omelette.exe. Oh, yeah. I didn't do anything. Name yourself QWERTY. Or, did I spell Olette? Whoops. Yeah. You said Olette. I said omelette. We're just crazy. Hold on, let's try. Well, that's an actual name. Omelette. Right? I don't think it was anything. Oh. Oh my god! Huh. Seems God is dead again. Jesus. I hate it when salvation becomes impossible to grasp. Jesus, fuck. My sins are numerous and inescapable. Must be heading for unending flames. Time for penance is now. I must find salvation. Fairground. Fairground is slothful, gluttonous, and greasy. Plentiful supply of hedonistic sinners / thrill seekers. Yes. If I can save one poor soul, then God might just weep for me. What in the fuck? Jesus Christ. I don't like this. I want out. The carnival. Everything's demonic. Let's save even one damn soul. I mean, is salvation truly possible? Bastard narrator need to be raptured. Could always, you know, go try to save Jerry. A plan so divine it just might work. What in the fuck? Zero for zero, no rapture. Please don't bang on the glass, it won't save you. What in the... I... Mom, pick me up, please. Okay, I think, okay, hold on. I think I need something real quick. Yeah, here we go. I need this. Give me this, please. Save. Yes. Okay, I just, for the demons. For the demons. Okay. You're all like... Jerry, don't you fucking move. I don't know where a good place to put this is, but like, here, I guess. Okay. Well, chat, we're going into this hellscape together. I'm sorry if you wanted a nice, fun adventure, but, this is Little Hell. We're going in, strap in. We're taking my car, and we're gonna see where this fucking rabbit hole leads us. Donut, fuck you for making me put this in, because now I want to see what the hell this is about. Because I'm literally weeping blood. My name is still just Jerry, you know. How can I help you today? I wish to save your tortured soul ticket, Jerry. Is today opposite day? Well, the sky is hellish and red. Alright, so how are you planning to save my poor soul anyhow? Kind of considering just converting you to Catholicism. I hate to break it to you, pal, but I'm actually a Marxist. Religion is the opiate of the masses and all that nonsense. Rats! Have you considered not being a communist? With this celery? Can't say I have, no. Oh, shoot, I was so close to saving you, too. Hey, wait a minute. Aren't you that demon who lives in that tent next to the playground at the park? Oh no, my cover's been blown! Look, demon, I'm only telling you this because you might paint this booth with my guts if I don't. It's rapture day today. Yeah, let me move the gun a little more. Just put it right there above the text box. Rapture what? Rapture day, isn't that for religious people? Yeah, but... Didn't you try to convert me to Catholicism a moment ago? Surely that would make you a practicing Catholic, right? I never got baptized. I only self-converted earlier today. Okay, fuck it. I'm cutting to the chase because I can only take about 3 more dialogue options before you, from you before my soul shrivels up. Rapture Day is a day for people who haven't spat in the face of God. They say that on this day, all true believers in the world of God will be spared from all of this. They say that there's a better place in here, a more peaceful place where everything will be okay. But I don't believe a word of it. Look around, there's no one to save us. What kind of God could let something like this happen? God must be dead and we killed him or something? Anyway, that's Rapture Day for you, my demonic friend. Speaking of which, God, presuming he's alive, has a promotion on today, just for Rapture Day. One free ascension for all baptized believers. If you can somehow convince someone to baptize you, you can, I don't know, force God to beam you up like a scoundrel? Granted, it'd take a real heathen to mission acquired. Oh, dead God fucking must get baptized. Okay, go do that. Away from here. Hey, Ticket Cherry, by any chance, could you baptize me? I will drag you down to hell myself. Scuttle away. Wow. How extensive is this? Dialtown. Oh my god. I don't have any words. Jesus Christ. Give up on getting baptized. What happens if I try to save? Whoa, spook fallen gingy. Chapter 666, Die Town, your tent. Oh my god. Is this like fully, like, everything? This is so much effort. This is so much effort. It could be. I don't know. Find the raccoon. Okay, I'll find the raccoon. Dude, let's go up, down, downtown. Oh my god. Uptown, downtown, home of everything and everyone, not pure enough to be saved. Donut, did you know about this? Talk to God. God is dead. It won't let me select it. Honestly, no. Okay. We're going through this together. What in the fuck? To the local phone shop. Condemned body on premises. So we can't even walk as subway is on fire. What in the fuck? Oh my god, someone's descending! Oh, there's people ascending! Down, 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 where the air feels like it's on fire and the ground smells of sulfur. So what now? Call Randy. Victimize a nearby passerby. Scream into the ether. Scream into the ether. Ah, fuck! Why haven't I been raptured? I've been so good this year. You know, adding extra lie onto your mounting list of horrendous crimes and sins is hardly a good idea. Shut. Oh god, oh fuck, I want instant gratification so badly. I'd sell my soul to get into heaven. Or honestly, I'd sell my soul for an ice cream sandwich. Oh, hi, hi. Hi. Pardon me, fair goblin. But might I have heard that you're looking to sell your immortal soul? We're wasting our time, bro. This ear's a demon, I'm telling you. So, demons have souls too, you know? Like, demon souls. Alright. Wait, they do? Well, don't we, bro? Oh, shit, right, duh. Now, as I was saying, hey, Stitchy, you looking to sell? Because if so, we can definitely oblige. Who are you two? Also, nice skullheads. I just scream running bullshit whenever I feel like it. Yeah, sure. Okay, let me... Just keep that over here. Or, actually, yeah, you know what? It's fine. Just get it off the, screen. I don't have any, like, place for it. Hey, thanks. Introduce yourself, bro. My name's Stabby. I'm many things. A demon, a crook, an absolute bastard. But, above all else, I'd like to think that I'm a felon. Yeah, and I'm Gougie. My name used to be Shooty, actually, but, well, unlike Stabby, I had to pick a new name to fully adapt to my new job, thanks to us swapping out our gun and knife heads and weapons for skulls and pitchforks. Jesus Christ, you ever try to shoot a pitchfork? Not recently, no. Believe me, without some kind of pitchfork cannon, it's really more trouble than it's worth. You could always, I don't know, throw the pitchfork. Yeah, but then his weapon's legally classified as a javelin. I'm no longer legally allowed to touch those anymore. Okay. Cool horns, though. Thanks! We try to work the new heads into our routine, and... We, had a bit about being horny and dearly hoping people would take our deal, but it ended up just scaring folks off. Turns out it's really hard to get a bozo to sell their soul to you when they think you're a schmuck. Who'd have thought, eh? Souls are precious, you can't just sell them to anyone. You two look like schmucks, alright? Thoroughly cringe! You're in luck, I have no standards. Trying that horny bit, I might be able to be persuaded. Oh my gosh, all these are good answers. I think I'll probably go with the one that just says thoroughly cringe. Ah, shit. Yeah? You still want to sell us your soul, though, bud. Eh, sure, why the hell not, eh? Hey! I'm honestly shocked. Normally folks tell us to get lost once we start talking. Well, I'm not shocked. Its standards clearly aren't all that high. I mean, for crying out loud, it wants to sell its soul for an ice cream sandwich. You understand, I really want an I said sandwich, not sandwich. Important distinction. It's not funny, it's actually quite cringe, but sure, go off, I guess. Fuck you, it is funny. I told you it's a demon. That's pure unadulterated wrath right there. You owe me a wrapped peppermint, bro. Ah, shit, yeah. Wrath's one of the 7 deadly foibles, ain't it? They're not called foibles, bro. They're called, the 7 deadly oopsies. Oopsies. No, I don't regret buying this game. Oh my god. No, that's not it either. Is it? Wait, are you trying to say the 7 deadly sins? Oh, hey, that's it. Wow, you must have actually read the flashcards that they gave us demons on our first day, huh? You're both demons and you couldn't remember the word for sin? Hey now. We're still getting the hang of this whole demonic asswipe shtick. Yeah, we were just lowly lowlifes before the world ended. Wait, you're not lowlife bottom feeders anymore? Well, yeah, okay, we still are. But now we have horns and pitchforks. Your horns are pretty sick, I'll admit. Thank you. We can use them to gouge sinners. Theoretically. we haven't really been demons for all that long, to be frank. We're essentially just two schmucks without forklift certification yet. God, this game speaks to me! Yeah, we're pretty green if you catch my drift. Green? You're red! Everything's fucking red! He meant green as in new, but sure, throw a shit fit, I guess. Nice wrath, though. Thoroughly based in rapture. Just the idea of demons saying, that's pretty cringe, bro. Man, that's thoroughly based, bro. Like, on... on Beelzebub, bro. On Satan, bro. That's pretty based. You two don't seem all that competent at being alive, let alone demons. Yeah, see, being born was the easy part for me. It's everything after that I've been struggling with. You'd think that after this many years on Earth, it'd be better. I'd be better at all this. Also, yeah, being a demon is hard work. They gave us flashcards with spooky things to mutter at sinners on them and expected us to actually read them. Excuse me. Ah, ridiculous. I personally literally cannot fucking read. I've never tried, to be frank. Sounds hard. Yeah, I wouldn't be cut out to pitchfork cringe sinners. Hey, you'd be surprised. Before all this garbage, we worked for the mayor. Kinda. What do you mean, kinda? We were essentially government-assigned vultures. Okay, continue. So, you know, when the world ended and all, we presumed we were out of a job and junk, you know? It's pretty fucking difficult to scavenge for wallets with actual dead goddamn demons impaling every schmuck who happens to get too close to them, you know? But then Satan emerged from the underworld and made a beeline for Mayor Mingus's office. Yeah, he acted like a starstruck bozo in her presence. Turned out, he was actually a huge fan of her work and tactics and always wanted to meet her. So not only did he let her stay as mayor, but now she's, wait, what's her title again? Queen of the Underworld? Royal Hell Mistress of Agony and whatnot? Yeah, something like that. Anywho, since she got a promotion, so did we. We're now government-assigned demons. Fun Gingy don't care! That's epic, congrats you two. Hey, thanks. Say, you're alright, bro. The other demons come off as pretty fucking rude for literally no reason at all. No reason? They're demons, bro! Rudeness is, like, one of the seven deadly... It is not! Either way, what's up? Let's talk business and junk. Oh my god. Finally. How can I sell myself to the devil if I didn't get raptured the others? So what's hell like? You implied that the mayor's still running things around here, right? If that's the case, then how come the traffic lights are broken? They are all stuck on red. Oh, yeah. She unplugged 2/3 of the bulbs in the traffic lights and disabled the vroom vroom changey grid. Yeah, she said it was a waste of electricity since everything is red now. Yeah, even green lights are red lights. Isn't unplugging the traffic kind of... vroom vroom changey grid. That makes sense, I guess. You know, I used to be green. Way, like, pre-apocalypse? Yeah, aside from the eye, I'm identical to how I looked before. That head made a stitch together flesh? That isn't new? This thing? Nah, I've had this baby for years, long before all this. Gouji, are we safe? You're creeping me out, bro. Keep my bro up, bro. That's cringe, not gonna... God damn it. I'll grow some balls, you goddamn catfish. Catfish? I don't... Catfish are bottom feeders. You work for a cat. Are you not entertained? Alright, alright. Just... Are you even working for Mr. Satan, or like... No, I just do what I want. I just do what comes naturally. Sometimes I'll let spite lead me, but mostly I just see where the day goes. Stabby, I'm really not comfortable around this thing. We're, gonna wrap this deal up pronto so we can get the hell away from you, capiche? Yeah, I kinda don't want to. You two are schmucks. Wait, after all the time we spent talking to you, you're just leaving us high and dry? Wow. Fuck you. Hey, fuck you! I told you we were wasting our time, bro. Don't start with me, bro. If we don't start snagging souls, it'll be the mayor that we'll have to deal with, and trust me, you don't want that. Yeah. Wait, what were we saying again? Oh, right, yeah, I remember. Fuck you, Stitchy. Hey, fuck you too. Later, bozo. I guess we'll call Randy. Oh, God, I kinda... God damn it, man, pick up, pick up. Is your tum-tum less queasy today? It is. It's nicer now. It just needed a rest from VR, I think. The line's busy, you impatient demon. There's nothing you can... I know. Don't you think I know that? I can hear the ringing. What could he possibly be doing right now? Talking to another customer, mayhaps? It's an angry winky face. Scary phone. 1-800... Angry winky face. The world doesn't revolve around you, you know. You're not the sun. I am God here. I feel confident saying that now that God's, you know, dead, I guess. Nobody's around to smite me now for moving in on his territory. So you waited till the man died to hone in on his turf? You're a vulture. The future is now, old man. Hello? Oh my God, even the music. Hi, welcome to the end of the world. My name is Randy Jade, and I'm Randy for you. Oh, heck. I screwed up the greeting again. I'm sorry, demon, but my last customer claimed to have had tentacles. He described what he wanted to use them for in strenuous detail. I really wasn't cut out for this job before, and frankly, the demons who've called so far today are at least 15% weirder than my usual clientele. But not more than 25%, don't get me wrong. I'm sorry, demon. Can I help you with anything? Okay, this is thoroughly cringe and I'm slightly based, I am out. Aside from all this, so how's work been, Randall? Which job? I actually had two jobs up until recently, you know. I guess we can start with your current job then. Well, the hotline's been fine lately, for the most part. Most of my clientele are literal demons now instead of just figurative ones. Which isn't ideal, but, you know, it's the end of the world and all, so what are you gonna do, I guess? I'm honestly just glad we're still making enough business for me to keep my job. Actual demons pay to talk dirty to you? You're surprised? Pal, lust is one of the seven deadly sins. Those guys are freaky. You think their massive horns are just for goring sinners? Think again! Huh. What was your other job like? Well, I was a bird wrangler for animal control up until the other world ended. Did you get fired and made redundant? Nope! I quit voluntarily. Why'd you quit? Surely that must have been the more pleasant job between bagging swans and... this. Well, this job wasn't exactly a walk in the park before the world ended, despite involving a lot of walking in the park, but, well, now the swans have glowing red eyes, chant in Latin, and levitate. Even I have my limits, you know. Levitate? Randy, swans can fly, you know. Not without flapping their wings, usually. You were right to have fled. Yeah, I mean... I only worked two jobs to pay my bastard former boss gougy rent, but, well, the dumpster that I lived in is now on fire, so heck that, I suppose. If you don't need to pay rent and the world has literally ended, then why on earth are you even still working at all? I think I just need the company. Pathetic. Yeah, I know. So, is there anything else you need from me, demon? Aside from all this, have you heard any local news? Well, I've heard that our mayor is planning to run for another term, but the world has ended. Is she hoping to govern rubble? Well, as she says, society may have collapsed, but you're still stuck with me till my term ends. She seems to be doing pretty well with her new citizen base. She's running on a pro-pitchfork, suffering-centric platform, which seems to be doing very well with demonic voters. Single issue voters, am I right? So she wasn't raptured? Oh, dead lord, no. Have you seen her policy proposals? No. I think Satan will have to come collect her himself if we went out of her if we went out of town. Wait, is this line secure? Forget I said anything. Demons are great. I love pitchforks. Pathetic. I'm sorry. Is there anything else you need, demon? Randy, can you please baptize me? I'm sorry, you're asking me to baptize you? Pal, I'm a dirty talker, a mere telephone smut vocalizer, man. Where on dead God's green earth would I get holy water? I don't know, man. You go to the nearest convenience store. What convenience store carries holy water? Wait, do those places carry holy water now? Even if they did, do you think I have money? Okay, scratch that idea. Why not the local church? Pal, do you really think I'm going to be caught anywhere near that place? Let me guess, the place is riddled with demons? Oh no, much, much worse. There's a kind of this warlord encamped there. A warlord? What? Some demons track mud onto the clean carpet in the bank in Uptown, and the woman behind the counter went nuts. She picked up a mop, started dismembering demons, and her bloodlust is insatiable. She's taken over an entire block of the city, declaring it's kill or be killed. Man, it sounds like something gnarly must have possessed her body. Nope, as far as I know, she just really hated that job. Either way, you won't catch me anywhere near that place. Sorry. Though, if there's anything else I can do for you... Okay, well, Randy's not gonna help baptize us, sadly. I have no idea what any of that means. You wouldn't. Be gone from me. Okay, thanks for calling the... Aw. What an awful little man. Aw. I don't want to be mean to Randy, but it's my only choice. So let's victimize a nearby passerby. Hello, hello, then. Right, weird times these are, yeah? Score is bloody red, isn't it? Oh, you poor thing. Do you not speak English? I bloody well hope so, since me country invented the language. Wait a moment. Are you... British? Yeah, lad, and right chef to be. Also, got annoyed for fighting in the Falklands. Even got my Union Jack on his own. Or I'm as British as a scrummy Yorkshire pudding or that big bloody clock, innit? Spitely devoured cello boy for daring to be born in Britain. I despise England, I despise you, be gone bassoon boy. Let's devour him. Did you really have to do that? I'm a being right digested, ain't it? What can I say? I followed my gut. God, I hate you! Say, where'd the music go anyhow? Huh, I don't know. I'm sure it'll come back. It has to, right? Did you just devour the man who was making the music? Aw, shit. And the music was creepy anyway. I'm glad it's gone. Cringe. Quiet, you. Don't make me swallow a bag of carpet tacks next. Oil be good. God, I'm dying. I don't know what's going on anymore. Well, local scene of den of sin. One of the local apartment complexes. Tis but rubble now. Bummer. So where do you guys want to go now? We can go to the zoo, we can go to the burger place, we can go to back up to Uptown, or we can go to the outskirts. What do you guys think? We do have to find Karen, that's true. Let's go find Karen. Oh my God. To the bank. Oh God. What? We're gonna have to talk to Oliver. Oh God, it's so red. What would you like to do? Ring for a teller. It can't be saved, sad face. Hold on. Maybe I should put some like actual music on. Where is it? This is fitting music. Not really. Let's put on Minecraft music. I feel like if there was any kind of music that would be playing, it'd be Minecraft music. But nobody came, Lamau. I don't have that. I have to bring it up on YouTube. I guess yeah, that would be. But nobody came. I guess yeah, it's fitting music. What are the comments? Genocide rat monsters are stuck in a room with you. How depending on how you play Undertale, it can either be a relatable, wholesome game or a fourth wall breaking horror game. That's true. Oh God. The fact that this is Flowey's theme slowed down leads me to believe that Flowey is constantly following you. And this one, Flying actually seems to be genuinely innocent in the player's action until the very end, where it becomes extremely terrifying and realizes that the player is now unstoppable. God. Yeah, I forgot about that too. It was another comment saying when you're in the genocide route and you go to the Snowden shop, all that's left is a note that just says, "Please don't hurt my family." Jesus fucking Christ, I forgot about that. Ugh. Anyways, turn it down a little bit. Keep the demons a little at bay. Just a little bit. Nobody can. That's bullshit, though. Karen's always here, right? Apparently not today. Maybe the bank lets employees off for the end of the world. So without Karen, what's to stop this bank falling into anarchy? You better not do what I think you're gonna do. Steal the bank's pen on a chain! You monster! What? It's a free pen! If the pen was meant to be free, it wouldn't have been tied to the counter. Oh, come on, it's literal end of the world. That's no excuse to be rude. Who the hell cares? It's just a worthless little pen. If it's so worthless, then put it back. You know I won't do that. Evil. You'll never get raptured at this rate. Blow it out your ass. God. It makes me sad to think that I've actually done the genocide route a few times. I've done it, I think, two or three times. Maybe Oliver's here. It's just a skull! What would you like to do? Summon an employee. Hey, Oliver! What's up? Hey! Salutations, vile demon! Welcome to the apocalypse! Thank you, Oliver. I, Oliver Swift, the one and gnarly, shall be your guide. If you need anything from this humble popcorn dispenser, you need only ask. Oh my God. This place is looking pretty red lately. Oh, that's not just here, my demonic dude. Holo Dialtown is red now. Hell, I'm sure the whole world is at this rate. Actually, if we're truly in hell, let me just like also let me be in the void. Well, the hell can I add? Hold on. Color correction. Hue shift. There we go. Look at that. I'm trying to turn myself red. It's not really working. Oh, there we go. Alright, we're in hell now, everyone. Whole world would be. Can't say I've been to Jamaica very recently. Maybe the apocalypse is like a regional event. All I know is my attire matches everything around me now, so hey, things must be looking up. That's true, yeah. That's what movies are showing right now. Well, I'm gonna be frank with you, my demonic dude. We have no movie showing right now. Not one. Nada. I don't... Well, you see... All of our film has sorta melted. You might have not noticed, but the air is a tad on fire right now. I had no clue that film could melt until now, if I'm being perfectly honest. But hey, with how hot it is in here, we don't have to leave the kernel popper on, so that's a bonus for the old electricity bill. How on earth are you guys still open? Don't you mean how in the hell are you guys still open? Questions still stand, boy. How still in business? Oh, please. Do you have any idea what this place's average monthly revenue was pre-apocalypse? It was far from gnarly, let me tell you. I say apocalypse schmocalypse. If there's a market, I'm more than happy to seize it. I've stuck by Mr. Dickens through worse. Worse than the literal end of the world? Why, but of course! Although, the tentacles jutting out from his head are definitely new. But hey, we had three demons come in earlier to buy popcorn from us. That's two more customers than we had yesterday. And baby makes four. So, can I interest you in some popcorn and maybe a dispensed beverage? Is he carrying around? I checked the bank and she wasn't there. Ah, man, Karen's missing? I'd wager that she merely got raptured if I had her pegged for the religious type, but, 50% off all large sodas for demons. Something tells me the god-shaped hole in her heart is all full of horse instead. So you have no idea where she could be. Eh, beats me. I'm sure she's just doing dandy, though. Wherever she may be. Hey, wait a moment. That look in your eye... Did you steal the bank's pen on a rope? Only slightly. How could you? The pen on a rope, no less! Well, I can see why someone didn't get raptured. Blow it out your ass. It's the end of the world. I'll do as I wish. Uh-huh. Anywho, you need anything else, my demonic dude? Can you baptize me, Dad? Man, that sounds like a blast. Filling a squirt gun with holy nectar and just going to town on you? Man, reminds me of the time some wasp made a nest inside a crack in our wall and Mr. Dickens asked me to take care of him. Long story short, I filled up a squirt gun with bleach and decided to douse the nest. Don't do this. Don't do that. I did not win that war, exactly. So what happened to the wasps? Long story short, the cinema took care of the wasps on its own. Turns out that the environment isn't just deadly to customers and profits. Rip and rest, cinema wasps. 2022 to 2022, so no baptism? Well, we don't exactly have holy water just laying around in here. Something tells me that if I try to lug a drum of that stuff in here, it'd just evaporate. Now that I think of it, there's probably a reason why so many demons seem to enjoy it in here. Maybe the place reminds them of home. You tried ransacking the church down the street yet? Last time I tried to enter that place, I combusted. Oh man, that sucks. Eh, I'm sure they'll find someone to baptize you, my demonic dude. Now, is there anything else I can do for you? Something related to the dispense of popcorn, perhaps? Nope, that's all. Goodbye, Olive Man. Alright then, have a groovy day, my good buddy. God. This is fucking creepy. Again, I did not expect this to go... anywhere like this. So, there's that. Should we go to the local park? I guess, yeah, let's go to the park. Dang, God. He left the server. That's true. Oh, the park. You could go roll around in the scorched grass, unless you mind getting freshly torn out entrails stuck in your arm. So, what now? I can't even lie down in the grass. That sucks. To the nearby playground. Why not? What's that bouncing? Is it a... Oh, it's like a liver. No, it's a hand. It's a hand. It's a fucking... It's an open hand that's bouncing. Ah, the playground. The juvenile lair of the old one. So, what now? Summon the old one. Lost your only form of assured damnation. Prepare to summon the old one. Let's do it. What the fuck? Exactly 25.05 millimeters apart, candle to candle. Perfect. You know, this mightn't be the most optimal way to summon the old one. You think the horse mannequin is too gauche? Just a teensy bit, yes. Oh, I know. He's only 6 million years old, right? That's like a kid in Eldritch Abomination years. We are ready. Summon the old one. The only form of assured damnation. Let's do it. Old one! Wretched old one! I summon thee, oh wretched old one! Oh my God. Little Bolov? I can't understand what you're saying. Is that... You're not even attempting to speak English, are you? What? When is the world gonna end for real, old one? Incomprehensible. I met with a terrible fate. Thank you. I swear those tentacles are new. Where do you get them anyhow? I'm just not even gonna try anymore. I can't understand a single fucking thing that you're saying. Kid, got any cool demonic slurs for me? Alfmu. Tulum Dirfum. Right, yes, thank you. Hey, can you baptize me? Noof! Jesus. It doesn't get any better. English! Do you speak English? This is fake and gay. Leave my sight, demon. There he goes. Let's go back to Uptown Dialtown. There's still some other places we could go back downtown, so... Let's see what we can do. Let's go to the burger place. See what's there. Bunnies burgers. Relentlessly sniff at the glass like a hellhound, I guess. God. Think about how much meat they have in there. Who needs little heaven with that much meat? I'd already be in heaven. Good Lord, I'm not sure if I've ever seen you get this unholy. lust is one of the seven deadly sins, you know, which is a tad counterintuitive if you're trying to get rapture, you know. I crave the meat. Hey, you. Pointing to the Burger Man. Yeah, you. Shoo. No demons allowed, aside from paying customers. Really, you're shooing me away? I'm not a demon. You can't just... I will add your flesh to the pulsating mound of human meat that I use for my burgers. Frightened scurrying. Well, that didn't really work. I guess let's go to the zoo. Oh god. What horrors are gonna be here? Dialtown Zoo. Do not feed the ones. And there's just skeletons. Huh, the zoo sure has seen better days. Oh, so the apocalypse instantly destroys the zoo, but spares Bunny's burger joint? How is that fair? Do not feed the unholy ones, it says, actually. It's a little weird. It's not like, I don't know if it's my TV or if it's like OBS, but because of like just how much red there is, I think my TV or OBS is not happy. Blind demons don't eat people. Hey, I'm sure the flesh of sinners get a tad boring if it's the only thing you eat. So Bunny will let those demons inside, but not me? How is that fair? Well, do you have money? Wait, is that... Theoror? Oh my god, that is Theoror! He's dead! Huh. Seems to be, judging from the ridiculous-looking phone stash. Ha, get racked, bastard. Tell you sporting, is it? Kicking the man while he's down? Nonsense, I hope the fucker gets osteoporosis! Lord, you really are a demon, aren't you? Blow it out your ass. Speak to Theo Russell. Enter the zoo. You're not strong enough to face what lurks within. Lead the Russell Belt, Zookeeper, Explorer, and Corpse. Hey, Theo, what's up? Yes. Hey, Theo, how you feeling today? Yeah, I guess that sounds about right. This place sure has seen better days, eh, Theo? I was kind of hoping he'd move a little to make this more fun. Move a little? He's a corpse! This is when do corpses move? I don't know. Our founding fathers seem pretty content rolling around in their graves right now. Good one. Jeez, tough crowd. Please wake up, you mustachioed bastard. There's no fun if you don't reply to my epic zings. Look, maybe you should just move on. It's not fair! Right when I'm at my zingiest, he turns into a skeleton! Technically, that skeleton was always there. It's all the stuff around it that ended up rotting away. I don't care! Wake up! Theodore's a real skeleton now, and frankly, he still has less issues than you do. Nuh-uh. What's up, Hollow? We're in hell. Worst he has to worry about now is a broken femur, a band of roaming street dogs taking his torso away, or perhaps a calcium deficiency? You, on the other hand, need serious psychiatric evaluation. Nonsense! I'm an angel! You stole the bank's pen on a rope! Who told you? I was there. Alright, I've had enough. Say goodbye to the mustachioed skeleton so we can skedaddle. Fine. Somehow I doubt that it'll leave your sight. I think you'll have to be the one to move away from it. I can say that. Just a hunch. Alright then, goodbye, you safari hat-wearing ass. Yeah, so the apocalypse... A little bit of backstory. In Randy's route on the dumpster, it says password omelet.exe. Donut had the idea of putting the omelet.exe in the name place because that's usually where you put like specific words. And yeah, now we're in hell. This is Dialtown, no longer Dialtown. So yeah, it's a place. Well, last place we haven't been to is the outskirts of town, so I say let's go there. So what now? Just wandering to the woods. The trees know. So we can't go. The only place left is the fun fair. What now? Leave. Okay, wow. Huh. Soullessly approach the ticket desk. Okay, hold on. Oh no, no, no! I've already told you, demon. I'm a Marxist! We're a godless, godless bunch. There's no saving pawn scum like me. Okay, Punish Jerry, I merely wish to ask a few questions. For the second and hopefully final time, demon, please don't call me Punish Jerry. Do you believe in an afterlife, Jerry? Well, legally I have to answer no to that question. My boss doesn't take talk of... Take talk... I know that's like an actual... That's fine in English, but something about saying that... Just weird. Of better things so kindly. Doesn't want his employees to get their hopes up. What if you think you're destined for hell, though? That's any hardly nicer than here, is it? You never worked at a carnival before, clearly. Oh, come on, it can't be that bad. How well would you sleep at night knowing there's a bearded lady or a man with gills pucking up cotton candy within 75 feet of you at any given time? Okay, never mind. Worst you'd have to worry about in hell is the fire / brimstone. Maybe the occasional overzealous demon with a pointy pitchfork. Hey, there's people out there who pay actual money for acupuncture. Isn't hell just involuntary acupuncture in an office with a broken AC unit? And the office has to be on fire. Maybe the office is in California. Got him. But I thought the point of the metaphor was that the office isn't literally in hell. In hell. Alright, enough of this hell banter. What else do you want to know? Why is this guy red, Ticket Guardian? Everything is red! Okay, fine, everything is red. So why is everything red? I think it's just the universe's way of saying you should all be very frightened right now. That can't be right. Trust me on this one. I'll even list all of Earth's red zones. 1. Rapture Day. 2. Inside of a pizza oven / active volcano. 3. That one nightclub where someone did cocaine off the top of my head after I passed out in the can. You sure are knowledgeable and wise, Punished Jerry. Don't call me... Alright, ask me something else now if you must. Can I enter the... Let's ask him if he can baptize us. I need holy water to do that. Or very chlorinated swimming pool water, perhaps. Would bottled water do in a pinch? Absolutely not. Bottled water itself violates at least 3 of the 10 commandments. It does? Thou shalt not steal from suckers who buy overpriced tap water. Thou shalt not lie to suckers who buy tap water and think it's better for some reason. And thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's oxen. Okay, I don't get what the last one has to do with bottled water. They add chemicals to it that make you covet cows that aren't yours. Man, that sucks. I guess a cabal of Satanists do run the world then. Cabal. It's really just the bottled water industry that they run, actually. But I'm pretty sure they have shares in the private prison complex industry, too. So, do you have any holy water around? Oh, yeah, sure. I've got whole barrels of this stuff just lying around. Can I have some? I was being... Look... Demon, I'm gonna level with you. I actually did buy a drum of it, just in case any wandering demons try to get into you, and, well, I sort of got thirsty, added orange concentrate to it, and drank it. You drank the whole barrel? A bit, yeah. Well, do you feel any holier? Excuse me. My body immediately tried to rapture itself, but since I was inside the hut, I just floated up, hit my head on the roof, and then drifted back down like a sad, deflated balloon. So, no, I don't feel holier. I feel like I have a concussion. Sucks to be you, Punished Jerry. You're too kind. So wouldn't you happen to have any chlorinated water around either, would you? Well, we do have a paddling pool out back, but the water's green. Oh, I'm green! Exactly. I wouldn't touch it if you're trying to get raptured. Ah, shit, you're right. Forget it. Oh, I'm sure you'll find someone else to baptize you. Maybe... Do you have any other questions, then? Can I enter the funfair human ticket dispenser? I don't think you'd want to. Really, why not? Well, most of the rides have melted for a start. What if I just want to grab a fairground hot dog? I'm sure the marauding demons inside ate any remaining wieners that were left and probably spat them out once they had a chance to taste the vile meat substitute that we use. I guarantee you that hell has better food than this place does. You think hell, the embodiment of intense suffering, has better food than here? I do, yes. What makes you say that? Well, I'm 98% sure that Satan gives better employee benefits than this place does for a start. The food thing, I'm just extrapolating.
Yeah.
You know what? I can't argue with that. All right, then. Are we done here? Yep, because that's all I got. Goodbye, Punish Jerry. Don't call me. Do not come back. Well, that was kind of sad. Is there. It might be time to let Jerry die. I simply refuse. Enjoy an eternity in hell. Angry face. Must figure out how to disembowel narrator. I'm a voice. I lack a corporeal form. I cannot be disemboweled. Bastard. What now? Yeah, there's. Is there anywhere else? Torture Paris with some more. Is there actually a way to exit here, or is there no exit? I'm pretty sure I did everything I could. I can't redo any of these. I kind of wanted to call back the guys. There's probs and end. Yeah, I'm looking around. I would assume there'd be an end, but I don't know. Let's try this again. Try sniffing on the glass again and see what happens. God. I want the meat. Hey, you. Yeah. You stop sniffing my glass, demon. You're spooking my paying customers away. Shoo. Go on, demon. Fine. When we gone, I'm gone, fucker. Do not come back, demon. Okay. Can't go to the casino slash bar. We can't go inside the zoo because the hero is fucking dead. Before I'm feeling more talkative. Ted, goddammit. Is there any place I didn't go? Back uptown. Can't go to the phone shop. I guess I can go back to my tent. That'd be the last thing to do. I guess I could give up on getting baptized, but I don't want to do that just yet. I feel like there has to be something, right? Pretty sure I talked to the old one as much as I could. What's up? Yep, it's fake and gay. Leave my sight. There he goes. There's no one here. Hilarious, I could just steal the pen. Maybe we can talk to Oliver again? His speech bubble didn't go away. So maybe Oliver is the looky who's back. Maybe he's the one that's gonna let us ascend. What can this humble popcorn dispenser do for you today? Maybe not. Good, goodbye, old man. Well, I'm pretty sure we went everywhere besides just giving up. So, I'll make a separate save, and we'll see what happens if I give up. Whoa, spook. Oh, it's futile. This venture has been in vain. I just can't find someone to baptize little old me. Oh, woe is me. Oh, calm down, my demonic friend. It'll be okay. It won't. Look outside. The cherry is crying blood. The sky is red. Demons are roaming the earth, and worst of all, God. God is dead. God is what now? What the fuck is going on in here? God, you're... Why does everyone think I'm dead? I was on vacation. I've been God for almost an infinity now. Surely I've earned a Wait. Where the hell is the music gone? Why have you... What have you done with cello, boy? Oh, I've been bored, ain't it? Oh, you. Hang on. Why is everything tinted red? Oh. Kick me, I'm God. Oh my gosh. Hey, we're all fine now. Woohoo! Yay! Everything's back to normal. This is cringe! What the hell happened while I was gone? Hey, you said hell. It's funny because of the... You think this is funny? Only slightly. This is no laughing matter. I encountered Jerry earlier and the guy was talking about Marxism. Who taught him that word? Everyone outside is trying to self-convert to Catholicism. Did you do this? I would never do something so depraved. That is clearly the pen on a rope from the bank. How'd you even access this reality? That pen is timeline exclusive. You did this, didn't you? I swear I didn't. Wait. Oh, it was that fucking clown, wasn't it? That's some kind of eldritch abomination through the universe's cat flat, I bet. I swear to me when I find that fucking clown. You just can't trust a fucker named Frongles! It was Frongles this whole time! Fool me once, shame on... Oh, good, so I'm not responsible for any of those. Good gravy. Oh, you most certainly are. I dropped you off here from your base timeline and made you my emergency contact right before I left for my holiday in case something like this happened. I wrote my cell number down on a piece of paper for you. I don't remember any of this. Are you sure I'm not just totally innocent of any wrongdoings? I like the sound of that, personally. Yes, I'm quite sure. I distinctly remember you tucking the piece of paper into your fanny pack and saying, I will never forget that you gave this to me. Oh, right. Yeah, okay, that sounds familiar. So wait, if you can fix this instantly, then what's the big deal? The big deal is this is a hell of a mess to get back to. Please don't say it. You said hell. Just take your ending and go. The ending where the world ends. That was amazing. Well, that was fun. We had some good times there in hell, huh? Oh my god. Well then, Donut, that was a good idea to put that in. Okay. now we can start a new route for real this time. And we'll try and see Bigfoot. Okay, what is our name going to be this time? And it's not fucking omelet.exe. What do you guys think? What should we make our name? Jesus, man. Grug. I like that name. Phonehead. A chimp trapped in orbit and poorly adjusting to zero gravity. Let's go. Grug. Alright. Where'd you like to go? We gotta go to downtown, and we gotta go out to the outskirts. Downtown. I'm assuming this is where the last guy is anyways. It just seems like the most... It just seems like the place he'd be. The woods. What now? Okay. Before we do this, actually, let me take a quick break. Get some energy back. I got some gummy worms here. When was the last time you guys had gummy worms?
I got them at Target. Usually they're only 99 cents. So they upped the price to like $1.20. I'm like, what the fuck? And they also like... They taste a little different. I don't know what it is. But it just kind of like tastes a little different. They upped the price and they changed the taste. I don't know what it is. And things are... Fucking things are just getting more expensive, man. Sucks. All these companies raising their prices on shit. I'm like, bro, I ain't got fucking money. How the fuck you expect me to buy a product when I don't got money? It don't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Get sense because money? Ha ha ha! Anyways, how you guys been? A little heart to heart here. Because, I have a few more worms left. I don't got many left. Shout your pants. Why didn't you say that for me? What's wrong with you? Anything else besides shitting your pants? Anything cool and neat? Any new games? Any new movies or whatever? That's fair.
It's just, you know, it's about that time. It's about murder, you know, murder a hobo time. Just about. Wander into the woods. Never would have gotten me one of those things again. A brain tumor? Wasn't expecting that. No, the other thing. Anal hemorrhage? No, the other thing. Oh, no. Oh, God, no. You don't have an idea, do you? See, what, pray tell, is the idea? I'm thinking I just ditch my clothes and gallivant off into the woods. Yeah, no, that didn't go so well last time. I got out of the bear trap in the end. Your bear trap. You set it up, as you may recall, in case, and I quote, a motherfucking grizzly do be approaching. FYI, I was right. A grizzly bear did appear. Actually, that was just an underpaid performer wearing a bear suit from the nearby funfair who was attracted by your rapturous gurgling. Right, what an ass. It was nice enough to call emergency services for you. Right, but what did the ambulance driver say to me when they pulled up? You know, the mayor only allows you one of these trips to ER a week. See you next Tuesday, you lime-hued fuck. In fairness, you are a threat to civilization. So in that case, the best thing for me to do is to leave it behind, right? Or just adapt your behavior to be less... Pass. You have mod powers? Let me think. How many channel points you got? $6.9K. Is that true? Her dial town. Oh, hi, Senna. The sex number. It's very tempting. It's a lie. I'll show you meatball kitten. Shut up. Give me, okay, before, give me one thing you plan to do with the mod powers before I give them to you. Give me one example of what you're going to do with your mod powers. Literally nothing. That's not an example then. Ban me. Alright, fine. That's what I would do and I told you. Yeah, fair enough. You want me from me, stupid? Fuck you. Fuck you, slut. There you go. Is that what you wanted? Is that what you wanted, huh? Little slut, huh? I know you will. It'll be funny. I'm just wandering to the woods for now, for real. What is that, Senna? What do you have to tell me? It's been a while, Senna. Sorry I haven't talked in, like, a few years. Day 14. I've been wandering woods for what seems like an eternity. I haven't seen my darling in what seems like years. I've grown quite weary and my feet are sore. I've had enough of these goddamn trees, Dad. Come pick me up. You're wandering for 3 minutes, Grug. Wait, only 3 minutes? Yeah, give or take. Man, nature sucks. You're fucking welcome. Cause now I'm a little hyperfixated myself. Man, I was over that shit back in 2019. Yeah, I've escaped it 5 years ago. It was like 5 years for me too. I played through the series in 2018. Oh God, no. Donut, no, Donut is not a Byakuya Kinney. What are you talking about, Senna? I do not agree. He is. I do not agree. Well, actually, I have no idea how I talk to them in DMs. I guess, okay, that's true. I don't know that, so he could be. Okay, so I know what, like, a kin is. It's like whenever a person literally thinks they're a character. Is that what the same thing as a kinny is? If we're going to be talking about this. I literally called me a whore in my dream. It's painful. You know what that means, Senna? That means you're a Toko Kinny. Not you too. I told them. Can't do this. Oh my god. I didn't fucking want to accept it. I think that's exactly what that means, Senna. If you're seeing Byakuya in your dreams, and Byakuya's telling you you're a whore, then yeah, that means you're a Toko Kinny. The Tokusi. God. Yeah, Senna is now, or Annie is now, fully in the series because of me. They wanted to play through the games, and I was like, hey, do you want to play through the games with me? And they said yes. And that was that. And now we are... They talk to me about it every time. They have to go to their other Danganronpa friend. You've been held at gunpoint while Senna plays through the first one. Oh, now Senna's playing through the... Wait, is Senna playing through the first game with you now? So that Annie... Yes! I created this circle of violence and I am proud. Game sounds every time Yagi comes up on screen. Okay, what chapter are you at? Finish your report card. Good. Pretty sure chapter 5. Okay, you're almost done then. What was your reaction whenever Byakuya said there's a traitor among us? We all lost it. Good. Because it's the best. It's the fucking best. Oh, man. I'm so glad you guys are going through it. You guys are... I don't know. You... An absolute cacophony of Among Us, yes. This is my fault, and I am happy that it's my fault. Because now you guys are in on it, too. Senna, we are the ones bringing the despair that is the entire Danganronpa series. So, are you going to go through... So, Senna, are you going to go through the same thing that I'm going to go through with Annie? Because I can't do this again. You don't understand. I can't do this. You're doing it. I did bring despair among you. You're doing it. You started. You can't stop now. That's pretty much how I did with like... So whenever Annie and I finish V3, we're going to do Ultra Despair Girls. And then we're going to watch the entirety of 3 as well. So while it isn't the entire series, it's all of the canon series. Is your favorite DR game? I only played through it once. Which, I mean, I played with all the other Danganronpa games once, but, I just don't remember much of it. I think I went through it, like, as quickly as I could. So maybe going through it again after V3 will be a good refresher. I ran about the lore for about 30 straight minutes at one point. There is so much fucking lore in this series. There's so many also branching paths. There's Danganronpa If, there's Danganronpa Zero, which actually, I don't even know what the fuck Danganronpa Zero is. I at least know what Danganronpa If is. I haven't gone through Danganronpa If, but I don't even know what the fuck Danganronpa Zero is. And then there's Danganronpa S, which I spent probably way too much time in, and it's honestly not even worth it. All three different systems. I have a problem. Okay, that might be a small problem. Oh god. Ugh. Summer camp one, that sucks. It's boring, I hate it. It is kind of boring. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I have it on my fucking Steam wish list. Let me fucking take it off of there. Cause honestly, I don't want it. It's not worth. It's just not worth. Animal Crossing board game mode. It's literally, like, that's not wrong. It's as inconsequential as Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival. You're not wrong. It is. It's as inconsequential as that. It's just ugh. It's really not worth it. Yeah, like the writing isn't even by the same writer that did all the main entries in the series as well. It's by someone else, a different team. So all the writing isn't as good as the, you know, actual series, along with the game itself just being grindy and not worth it. Can't remember, briefly, but otherwise it adds nothing. You won't miss anything. Just look up interactions. Yeah, if you really want to see like the interactions, then just like at least the same minigame Monokuma's Test in V3 kind of had like a thing to do. There was achievements. There was a whole dungeon crawler aspect to it, but they just took that aspect out, and now it's just fight after fight after fight. That's not fun. At least dungeon crawling had something to it. Had bosses and like chests to get, and you had to level up all you had to create armor and weapons. Like there was something to that, to Monokuma's Test. That's why it was kind of fun. It made me at least want to come back to it in V3. In S, they just took all that out. It's not worth it. The only thing that's worth it, a love hate relationship in V3. I think I don't know if it's the best. It's definitely my favorite of the series. But whether that's the best or not is up for debate. Because I still think the characters of 2 are my favorite. But the general story and everything else with, like, gameplay-wise with V3. The game makes you mad. Why does it make you mad? I think it adds a decent amount of new stuff to this formula and changes things up and does new things. It's different enough that it's interesting to me. To the DR lore. Okay. Shh. 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 Yes, but shh. I said nothing. You may be right, but who was that? That was scary. I still love it. It's mindfucky, but I love it. Anyways, back to Dialtown. Sorry. It's just like what I've been dealing with, not dealing with, I don't want to say it like that. I mean, just what I've been doing. Yesterday, Annie and I, was it yesterday? I say it was Sunday. So yeah, yesterday, Annie and I went through the entirety of the prologue in chapter 1 of V3, and we're going to continue on Thursday, and with chapter 2, probably just do chapter 2 on Thursday. So we're just doing really just like a chapter at a time, although we usually bunch the prologue on chapter 1 together and then like chapter 5 and 6 together, because usually chapter 6 just isn't that long. Aw, you giggled at me. Why? I wanted to cry right there with him. It was sad to hear them. God. Alright. See where your emotions lie, Senna. God. Anyways, Dialtown. Oh, that's true. If it was sad, then, you know, your game gets more sad, but anyways. Leaves don't do shit. Well, neither do you. Touche. Wait, hang on just a moment. Oh, God. I feel different suddenly. Like I'm losing my manners, my urban instincts. What manners? I feel like I'm becoming feral. You're already pretty feral. Oh, God. I can only remember... excuse me. I can only remember the smell of Papa's stove. What are you talking about? I've gotten rogue. I'm off the chain now. There's nothing to stop me from shredding my clothes and going gaga. You actually shred those 90 seconds ago. Oh god, what's stopping me from eating some dirt? Please don't. My hog instincts are kicking in. Must dig for truffles. Okay, you know what?
fuck it. Go muck about in the dirt if you insist. You'll just eat 4-ish pine cones, get tired and or hungry, and then walk back to the road, which is very much part of civilization, might add, to pursue the nearby ditches for roadkill. Wait a moment. Do you see those? What? Dirt? No. Footprints. Oh my god. Lady Gaga, yes. Okay, yeah, so, don't you miss what this means, dear narrator? Oh, not this. Ape-man hogwash again. Yes! Look, you've been pacing in circles for the last minute or so. These are probably yours. Psst, wrong answer, biznatch. If these footprints are mine, the claw marks would be much thinner. Right, your elongated toenails. My claws, yes! This be Bigfoot! Right, fine. Maybe these tracks aren't yours, but the last 6 times you found Bigfoot tracks, they either turn out to be bear tracks, human tracks, or in the last case, gorilla tracks, made by an escaped gorilla from the zoo.
Oh, yeah. Bigfoot.
I came close to that last time. Dude, following those gorilla tracks just wound up leading you to the escaped gorilla, which was not pleased to see you. Dude, same. Same, Senna. I disagree. Yeah, to eat you. Poor thing was clearly starving and he thought you were a bamboo scarecrow being pale and green. In fairness, the gorilla didn't bite me that hard. You still have a massive scar on your collarbone, which is amazing given that gorillas now lack visible mouths. Call you. Well, maybe once you get to Ultra Despair Girls, you can dream of the dreams that Toko has. Which, speaking of, how are you going to go through the series? Are you going to go through the series the same way I am with Annie? Or, please, are you going to go through it in, like, kind of chronological order? Like, are you going to do Ultra Despair Girls next, then 2, then 3, then V3? Or are you going to go 1, 2, V3, UDG, then 3? Because I'm going forward in time and then going back, fucking around, finding out. True. I did say after the end of each... After end of 1 and end of 2, I was like, so, Annie, what do you want to go? Do you want to go this way, this way, this way? And so I just, like, they weren't too sure, so I was like, well, we can go on to V3, because there's barely any mention of UDG and 3 in V3, and also V3 is the most, like, 1 and 2, obviously. But, anyways, it all worked out all right in the end, didn't it? Right until Theo, Russell Belt, Dialtown resident zookeeper, and Weirdo showed up, tranquilized you both, and took you back to the gorilla enclosure to the Dialtown Zoo. But I'm free now, aren't I? It was still an ordeal that could have very simply been avoided by merely, I came so close that time. Bear? Man? Gorilla? Each time was closer than the last to finding Bigfoot. One more time, one more go is all I need. Good God, Grug. Haven't you ever heard the expression, curiosity killed the cat? Curiosity kills the cat, then I go eat the cat. No, please, Grug. I implore you to reconsider acting out whatever depraved idea might be swirling around in that green noggin of yours. Grug, please. 10 minutes of craze assembly later. Please, I beg of you. Explain your plan to me again. Why? The plan's foolproof. It couldn't be simpler. You think I need a longer piece of string? I think you need to start again from scratch. What? What part of this do you find so unworkable? Oh, just all of it. Poppycock, have you ever watched cartoons as a mere kitten? Never gazed upon the wild coyote as he sprang nefarious traps? All in his vain pursuit to catch the fast ostrich? Uh-huh. And how did that work out for the scheming canid in question? Silence, shout lobe! If I say shout lube, that's not right. This is the most optimized trap in the world. Explain it to me. Bigfoot takes the cheddar, I pull the string, the ruler and box both fall over. He's trapped under the box, I win. Okay, so quick sidebar. Firstly, why is the lore cheddar of all things? You think he prefers stinkier cheese? I think it's bold of you to assume that Bigfoot would eat cheese and not, say, the flesh of children. Bigfoot does not eat kids. A child on a giant mousetrap is just asking for trouble. That's actually quite a sensible thing to say. I had my reasons not to try the flesh of child or bait mousetrap. Yes, and were those reasons, 1, that you liked a nearby small child, 2, you liked a comically large mousetrap? Guilty murmuring. Why not tempt him with something a tad sweeter than cheddar or the flesh of lost children? Say, chocolate. Bad idea. Dogs can't eat chocolate, so who knows if Bigfoot can? Can gorillas eat chocolate? I mean, we can, so they probably can, right? Alright, for the sake of argument, we'll go with human rules then. To be fair, there's also lactose intolerant people. I swear if you even pitch feeding Bigfoot soy products, implying lactose intolerant humans count as people. So true. That's... If Bigfoot was lactose intolerant and heard you say that, $10 says that he turned hostile and tear your head clean off. Bigfoot would never do that. Bigfoot and I are kindred spirits. God damn it, Krug. Bigfoot is not... No. It couldn't. Could it be? Sasquatch! Oh god, fucking dead. My persistence, my diligence, it has finally been rewarded. Sasquatch, my love. Shh, it's okay, it's okay. Come on, big guy. I have a banana. Where'd you get that? Shh. Come here, baby, come here. I hate this. I hate all of this. Shut fuck, narrator. Bigfoot is... No, shh, it's okay, it's okay. I wasn't yelling at you, darling. I would never do that. Huh. How dare you anger me in Bigfoot's presence? For years, years! Oh, relax, he'll be back. He saw the nanner. He did see the nanner, yes. Still, Bigfoot is easy to startle. We know that now. But of course he is. Did you honestly think Bigfoot had escaped nearly all detection by mere coincidence? Well, my gut told me he was hard to find because he ain't real, but now I'm questioning a lot of things I thought I knew. Bigfoot is 40% motion blur, 30% hair, 20% mystery, and 20% good gravy. That adds up to 110%, you know. There's at least 10 extra percent mystery, damn it. This is Bigfoot math. I ain't gotta explain shit. Oh. There he is. Whoa. Easy does it. You want the banana, boy? You want it? I just gave him the banana, man. But we don't know how easily he angers. Do you think Bigfoot can feel anger? I'm sure Bigfoot never hurt me. Okay. One nano exchange coming up. What do I think? What do you guys think? Give him the banana? Or, one of these other two options? Nano? Okay. Oh. He's a camera. Seems to like bananas. Are you surprised? Heck yeah, he does. I wish he liked me that much. Heck yeah, he does. I guess it figures that he'd like bananas. He's an ape man. Apes like nanners. Men like nanners. I guess we were just hedging our bets. Bigfoot, my love. The bananas seem to have calmed him down, alright. He's nice and docile now. I think we're ready for first contact. Oh my god. They touch tips. I've done it. I've tamed Sasquatch. I mean, have you really? He's a feral ape man from God knows where. Probably has fleas, you know. Should I delouse Bigfoot? I think you should remember your primary objective. I believe my primary objective was to find Bigfoot, actually. You are still heavily pregnant, don't forget. You still gotta lay those eggs. Oh my guts. You know I'm right. Oh, I hate this. I hate you. I'm sorry to pry you from fucking Sasquatch, but you still have to overcome your greatest hurdle yet. Ticket Jerry. Oh, damn him to oblivion. All right, Grug. Time to say goodbye to Bigfoot. I can't believe I just had to say that sentence out loud. What the fuck? Sasquatch, my one true love. I guess this is goodbye. Ooh. I'm sorry. I must go now. Ooh. Oh. What's wrong, boy? Are you trying to tell me something? Ooh. What is this? Is this for me?
He has a family! Is your family Bigfoot?
Ooh.
Oh no. The government, they took your family, didn't they, boy?
Ooh.
Nope. Nuh-uh. I am not feeling bad for motherfucking Sasquatch. Have a heart, narrator. Please take a firm step back and realize that you're asking me to pity a semi-mythical ape man. I just can't abandon Bigfoot. Not like this. I can't just leave him on his own again. Grug, what about your eggs? What about Ticket Jerry? Wait. I can use Bigfoot. Oh no. I beseech you, Grug. Please discard that notion. I beg of you. It's ape time, narrator. Oh my god. No, don't excite Bigfoot. You stop that. The wheels are already in motion, baby. Ape train full speed ahead. This isn't an option. How on earth could you use Bigfoot to bypass the ever stoic Ticket Jerry? Ooh. Alright. Well, what should we do? Use Bigfoot for good or use him for evil? Use him for evil. Use Bigfoot to destroy Ticket Jerry. Let's do it. Fuck it. I should use Bigfoot for evil. Boy, that's a sentence I sure never thought I'd have to say. Grug, it's all very simple. Bigfoot is an ape man. He is stronger than we could ever need. Sasquatch is ripped, jacked, and thoroughly shredded. Alright, okay. Bigfoot is excessively powerful, sure, but I don't get how that solves... Oh, you're not. Yes! Bigfoot will kill Ticket Jerry, our final obstacle. Yes, my dear Sasquatch, I will teach you all about manslaughter. Please don't teach Bigfoot that it's okay to kill humans. I feel like that's a switch we won't be able to unflick. I have already decided. I declare murder to be legal for all nearby ape man. Yes, my dear Sasquatch, you are untethered now. Yes, harness that rage, my boy. All right, spill the plan then. I feel like if I know what's about to happen, I may just be able to stop it. Okay, so first, I'm going to bring Bigfoot to Ticket Jerry. How are you going to lure him over to the ticket booth? Do you have a second banana, perchance? You know I don't. I didn't know you had the first. I'll just fish a collar leash out of the dumpster, I guess. Maybe take both from a dog tied to a pole outside a supermarket. Okay, so you've graduated from ape manslaughter to stealing from a literal dog, so... Come on, the hound is man's best friend. I am no man. I am goblin. I really don't like the arc that you've undertaken as of late. From what I can see, your character development has been solely comprised of egotism and petty crime thus far. You consider coaching Bigfoot to murder a petty crime? Pal, I don't think the laws that govern us have a pre-existing category for training Bigfoot to murder civilians. This will have to go straight to the Supreme Court, without a doubt. But my eggs will have to be laid by that point. I'm on the pig's back. Think I sent to the big house? There or Area 51? Yeah, honestly, I think the feds would love to take a nice probing peek at what's inside you. Oh dear. But have you also considered what'll happen when you bring Bigfoot to the funfair gate? We've been over this. He wrecks Jerry's shit. I enter the funfair. Easy as. Have you taken the fact that Bigfoot is a feral ape person into consideration? Yeah, right. I'm sure violence is right up his alley. If it isn't, I could always coax him. Assuming you are able to motivate Bigfoot to slaughter Jerry at work, have you considered that Bigfoot will somehow have to get into Jerry's enclosed office? He just smashed the glass with his ape knuckles. The bulletproof glass? The glass isn't bulletproof. Funfair said it was in the news recently. Had to replace the old glass with bulletproof glass for legal reasons after the coaster flew through the glass and flattened the last ticket, dude. I could have just lied for insurance reasons. Clutching at moist straws here, pal. I'm sure Bigfoot he can... Ah, oh, shit, I've got to revise our tactics. Mark my words, Bigfoot. When we are done here today, you will have all the training you need to successfully murder and devour Ticket Jerry. Ooh. Did one of those words excite you, boy? Was it murder?
Ooh.
Training?
Ooh.
Devour? Okay, this I can use. I don't like this. Civilian to use Bigfoot for war. Task 1. Preventing civilian casualties. Alright, boy. With both of us standing deep within the remote forest that envelops Dialtown, we can practice without presenting an extreme danger to nearby civilians. Dude, we aren't any further away from civilization that we've been at any point earlier on today. Nuh-uh. There's a busy road right behind you, you know. Yeah, well, we don't know that Bigfoot knows what cars are. We're training him to kill people, not giant metal insects. Do you think Bigfoot can drive? Yes, next question. Right, and why are you so sure? You think Bigfoot walked from Oregon to Texas and then somehow to here? Bigfoot has been spotted in Arizona, man. Can you really picture Bigfoot trekking across a fucking desert? I can't say that I can, no. Pal, Bigfoot drives. If not, he must know how to hitchhike. And if not, he knows how to fuck. Bigfoot, do your best, hitchhiker. Yeah, see? Who on earth picked up Bigfoot and drove him within walking distance of here? A fellow lover of ape, of course. A connoisseur of all things Squatch. Anyway, since we are away from civilized society, it is time for your first lesson, Bigfoot. Yes, you see, my beloved and primitive friend, our enemy is none other than the one and only bastard man, Ticket Jerry. Scorn him, for he is our omnipotent hurdle. Oh, right, you're lucky I haven't met Ticket Jerry. Nara, do you think Bigfoot has been to the fun fair? As sternly amusing as it is to imagine an elusive A-man cheerfully riding a roller coaster somehow... I know that Bigfoot would cope well with the blinding neon lights. Nada. Another cacophonous roar of loosely held together contraptions surrounding him. What, too bright, too loud, make Ape-Man go, ooh! You see? Like that. Huh. You best physically describe Ticket Jerry to him. You are attempting to teach Bigfoot to commit manslaughter, after all. That's a dangerous power to abuse. Blow it out your ass if I want to use Bigfoot for needless violence, I shall. At the very least, don't harm innocent civilians. Aside from the aforementioned Ticket Jerry, if you must, who, need I remind you, is also an innocent civilian. I do need to ensure that Jerry doesn't get away in the chaos somehow. Jerry shall be Bigfoot's primary target. Okay, Bigfoot, I'll describe Jerry to you now. He has a brown head. It's kind of old. Or, wait, is it gold? It's definitely a phone of some kind. Can you even picture Jerry right now? Seriously, Ticket Jerquin? What do you expect from me, Dream Jerry? You know how much prescription cough syrup I'm on right now? Trick question. None of it is prescription, and in fact, local medical practitioners shoot you away with comically large mallets whenever you ransack their offices looking for more. Whoa, you lie. Who are you trying to fool here? I'm inside your head. Enough, bye-bye, Jerquin. Why was Jerry a penguin anyhow? He gives off that vibe, I guess. What vibe? What vibe do penguins give off? I'm sure Jerry could slide on his belly, but I doubt he can fly. Therefore, penguin. I mean, by that logic, Jerry's likely a horse, because he'd kick you in the head if you snuck up to him from behind, and... Well, I'm sure there's some convoluted method you could use to make glue out of the man when he gets to retiring age. Consider the glue option. Skip glue notion. What do you guys want to do? We want to consider or skip the glue notion? God, this fucking game. Fuck. Oh, this music too. God damn. Okay, well, let's skip the glue notion. Let's have a glue shtick. Back to square one. Maiming Ticket Jerry. With that in mind,
What do you think would happen if I unleashed Bigfoot on the unsuspecting public? With the level of training you've given thus far, sure, why not? Presuming Bigfoot understood any of this, I think Bigfoot would definitely maul innocent civilians. He might make a beeline straight for the zoo and eat a few penguins, I don't know. He'd probably gotten the poor ape all muddled. Either way, you'd go to prison for war crimes once they find out you were behind this. Prison? I ain't going back to the big house. I can't live behind bars again. Okay, plan B, process of elimination. Alright, Bigfoot, listen very carefully to me, okay? This right here is a civilian. Where'd you get that picture? Sold it from the bank, tore it off the wall. Was hoping to ransom it for $2 to buy a funfair ticket. But this plan is far better. Evil teeth-blazing chimpanzee grin. You're despicable. Shut. Again, Bigfoot, this is a civilian. Do not harm these. That'd make you a war criminal. Yes, Bigfoot, a war criminal is a bad thing to be. Here, I'll let you get a closer look to make sure you understand. Well, this is promising. You see, I think he understands that. Okay, see, Bigfoot developing a taste for human flesh isn't quite ideal. Jeez, Bigfoot for war? Task 2? Teaching Bigfoot hand-to-hand combat! Oh my god. Alright, Bigfoot, now I'll teach you basic combat skills. Oh, please don't do this, Grug. It's distressing enough knowing that Bigfoot is real and constantly lurking nearby. Giving the ability to do arbitrarily snap people's necks might just send me over the edge. I don't know, Bigfoot, do you want to learn how to snap necks? Do not listen to the monkey. He doesn't know what he wants. Bigfoot's done more to convince me of his trustworthiness than you have. I'll side with the ape judgment on this one. God damn it. Bigfoot. Today I will teach you the cornerstone of all truly effective fighting styles. The karate chop. What? You don't know karate. Bigfoot doesn't know that. Probably. Please don't goad Bigfoot into hurting himself. Bigfoot's fate is sealed. It is karate time. Oh my god. Bigfoot, please observe the karate chop. Got my fucking hand! Bigfoot, don't try this at home! Oh, for the love of Krungus, that's smarts! Youch, youch, youch! Alright, Bigfoot, now you try. What? Stop that! You just injured yourself, and you told him not to try this! At home! Yeah, but we're not at home, we're in the woods. This is Bigfoot's home. Do you really want to put Sasquatch through the pain you just received? If he injures himself, this plan kind of goes out the window. Plus, I'm sure he counts as, like, an endangered species or something. If he perished due to a suggestion of mine, I'd, like, go to prison and stuff. Can Bigfoot really be classified as an endangered creature? Are you kidding me? Dude, one speedy pickup truck could potentially make Sasquatch extinct. Stop it, you're scaring him. Wait, again, why am I starting to care for him? I don't like this! Plan B, Bigfoot, let's try a few practice chops first. Show me your best air chop. Whoa! Wait, what was that? Pathetic, what a meager, pitiful aerial slice. Ooh. Oh, come on, give the poor ape a break. This is like his first ever karate chop. No, no, no. This is Sass motherfucking Sasquatch we're talking about here. I assumed he would have at least had the basics of karate down. Why would you assume that? No further questions at this time. Try again, Bigfoot, but this time. Pretend that you're slicing a massive banana. See, there you go. I see how this works now. You're bestowing a dangerous amount of power on the simple fuzz creature. If Bigfoot sees a man in a banana costume, he will commit manslaughter. Or, legally speaking, banana slaughter? He's so close, though. Alright, Bigfoot, if you ace this next one, I'll give you a banana. Yes, my fellow's in the end thrall, yes. Chop like you've never chopped before. Sasquatch, you pitiful thing, you! Oh, you want your banana? I lied, I don't have a second banana. It was a miracle that I even found the first banana, as a matter of fact. That was a ballsy move, risking and angering an ape man that you just taught karate. Okay, I've got a plan B. Whiskey, next best thing. Yes, Bigfoot, whiskey. I intend to get you all liquored up for phase 3 of the plan. Phase 3? What's phase 3? Oh my god. He's Bigfoot for war. Task 3. Children are squishy. Might as well use them before their bones stop growing. Oh my god. Can I just say that phase 3's title alone makes me distrustful? Come on, you've been negative Nelly all day. I feel like training Bigfoot to beat up kids is a very kind thing to do. Or isn't a very kind thing to do. Oh, she said that about teaching Bigfoot karate. Yeah. Also, why is Bigfoot wearing a fedora? Disguise. Yeah, see, he gets it. I'm telling you, this is a bad idea. Plus, I'm telling you, this idea is good gravy. I don't want any part in this. Yuck, it's always morals with you. Loosen up, brave the waves. Morals? Oh, no, you must understand. I just don't want to be charged as an accomplice. Find another thought being to occupy your noggin and you spend the next 40 years in prison. Ciao. Well, that was dramatic. Well, it's just you and me now, Bigfoot. You'll have to play the straight man for the game's one joke to work, alright? Oh, fuck, this isn't gonna work. Randy! Hey, I'm really sorry to bother you. I just wanted to ask you... Is that Bigfoot? Oh, him? Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, that's Bigfoot. Huh. Stranger, Bigfoot. Bigfoot, stranger. My name is Randy. Bigfoot doesn't care. Was that... Did I upset him? No, he just does that. There's a lot of overwhelming sights, sounds here, I'm sure. Uh-huh. What in the fuck? That was an interesting noise that my air conditioning just made. It made the sound of a car starting up. I don't like that the air conditioning unit is above my head. Shut up. I don't know if that picked up on the microphone, but that was an interesting sound. What are you doing on a playground anyhow? Are you trying to recruit some kids to help clean your tent? Take it from me, don't bother. Child labor laws are a bitch. It's still going. What? No, I... I'm gonna keep my voice down. Wise. I just came over here to see if any of the kids had a Band-Aid on their knee that they might be willing to donate to me. I'm bleeding a lot. In my experience, Dialtown's children are a stingy, worthless lot. I don't know, why not ask one of the parents instead? They tend to be more charitable since they've, you know, developed empathy and all. That and mercy. Not for old Randy, I'm afraid. I'm sorry, did you bring Bigfoot to Dialtown, or... Look, I'm not judging, but the idea that Bigfoot was in my general vicinity without me knowing kind of disturbs me. Oh, I just found him in the nearby woods, just chilling. He's pretty nifty, eh? He seems to really like bananas. God, whoops, now I've gone and excited him. Now, not now, Ape One. You'll get your nana when the job is done. The job? What job? Oh, I'm getting Bigfoot to test his combat skills out on some kids. What? That's horrible! Why would you do that? Soft, squishy bones. Not fully formed yet. Plus, you know, no consequences. There will absolutely be consequences. Oh, please. Is little Timmy gonna run and tell Mommy? What is he gonna say, huh? Mommy Bigfoot maimed me? Kids are fools. She'll dismiss the accusation immediately. Huh. Please don't let Bigfoot harm me. I can't ensure that won't happen, Randy. Alright, I'll just skedaddle then. Oh, but if any of the kids shed a Band-Aid during the beatdown, do you think you could call me over? I'll likely be rolling around at the bottom of the nearby pond, wrestling some kind of hostile snake-necked bird. All right, I'll do that, I guess, sure. Hot dog, middle class, here I come. No, but if I just said that so the bum leave us alone. If I found a used banny on the ground, I'd instantly consume it. Hey, ya bozo. Huh. Who's the gorilla dude? Gorilla dude? That shit child is sass motherfucking Squatch. Oh, it's a dude in a Bigfoot suit. Gotcha. Kid, that is the actual Sasquatch in the fur. Yeah, right. And I am Pope Gregory the Ninth. How do you know what that is? What age are you? I converted to Catholicism a week ago, bub, just for the hell of it. I don't like these connections to Dialtown. My soul's destined for hell anyways. Might as well get to drink priest wine before I get there. Billy, you even sold both Bigfoot and Catholicism in the span of 30 seconds. That's almost impressive, but also very evil. What's his gripe? That's the not really Sasquatch stick or the Catholic stuff. I don't know. Is Bigfoot a practicing Catholic? I mean, he chugged that whiskey like a champ. Maybe he drinks communion wine to mellow out? I don't know. Actually, you know, little Billy, I wouldn't make any sudden movements or loud noises. Bigfoot really doesn't like those. Loud noises and sudden movements, eh? Yeah, definitely need to avoid making both of those things, yeah. Hey, Ape Man, want to see something cool? I knew that was coming! Oh, now you've done it, you little shit! Alright, Bigfoot, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is, I was generally right about the plan. As predicted, Billy's mother doesn't believe the real Bigfoot beat up her son. But the bad news is, they're searching for a man in a Bigfoot costume instead. And since I was seen with you, they're looking for me too. Do you know what manhunt means, boy? Yeah, I think you do. I can hear the sorrow in your ape speak. That was great combat training, but maybe we should lay low for a while. Till all this dies down and Billy makes it out of the hospital. Oh, don't give me that look. Where'd you even find that hammer? Oh. I'm sorry, baby. Shh, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Practice on kids so no real people would care, remember? Oh. That was just a trial run. It'll all be okay. But since karate's off the table, I need to give you the next best thing. Oh. What I'm about to give you is what separates man from ape, Bigfoot. Orangutan from orang-a-man. Oh. Orangutan from orang-a-man. Behold, Bigfoot. Whap! What? The noble handgun. Oh. No, no, no. Oh my god. Hey, what did I miss? Well, this is a development. Oh. Buzz off, narrator. I'm handling this fine on my own. I leave for 10 minutes. Please tell me that Sasquatch acquired the firearm on his own, and this is a result of your incredible negligence and not a direct rejection of all things sacred and holy. Cough! Teach him a smith and lesson. Alright, that's my cue to leave again. Good luck with whatever this is. Wait, why'd you even come back? Forgot my ointment. Wait, if you're just in my head, how do you even have... Why did you drive off last time if there's a door out of my head? Huh, dramatic. Alright, Bigfoot. I'll explain to you how the noble gun redefined humanity's history. Oh my god.
Once upon a time, the world was untamed. Man lived among colossal dinosaurs and saber-toothed pandas. We had spears and rocks, sure, but against the dinosaurs, pah. We were hopeless, stuck in our caves, living in fear of the scaled menace. But then it happened. George Washington invented the assault rifle and also America itself, freeing us all. George Washington single-handedly penned the Second Amendment, giving all humans cannons. God smiled at his tiny apes and threw a meteorite at the Earth just for the hell of it. Oh god, oh fuck. Man struck the Earth kind of hard, causing all the dinosaurs to fly off. Except for the really heavy ones made out of bones, I guess. You're so lame, gross. That's where we get fossils from. I think we were fine because we were in caves, caverns, dank holes, and the like. Worst we would have gotten is us hitting our heads on the roof as we ragdolled. This is why cavemen were so dumb. That and Albert Einstein wasn't invented for a bit. The other threats that didn't fly off the Earth just sort of adapted to us being the new top dogs. Saber-toothed pandas ditched the funny teeth and became the noble trash panda. Now they eat our garbage instead of us. With humanity armed, raccoons wandered around and the dinosaurs all drifted off in space. We explored the Earth, cut down jungles, and covered the Earth in fast food burger joints. And it was good. This is what separates ape from man, Bigfoot. This is what makes you an American. If someone irritates you or insults how you park your pickup truck, you wrap your finger around the trigger and fire shots indiscriminately. And soon you'll be back in your grocery store mobility scooter buying canned beans. This is the American way, my dearest Sasquatch. Now then, let's go on to phase 4, how to purchase a cheeseburger. Oh god. Oh my god. But you don't want to. Oh my god. Fuck, I am wounded. Oh god, I can taste lead. I have soiled my britches and I am dying. At two, Bigfoot. My simple ape child, I feel as though I'm fading away. I don't understand. I made all the right moves. I taught Bigfoot to attack humans and gave him a loaded firearm. Oh, okay, right. I might see a vague correlation between the two now that I mention it. Simple ape child of the Earth, know this. You are not responsible for my death. And I'm certain that none of this is remotely my fault. Society is to blame. Society has slain me, Bigfoot. Oh, to die in Sasquatch's strong, hairy arms. This is how I always wanted to die. Thank you, Sasquatch, for everything. I think I'm going to hell now. The ending where Bigfoot kills you with a fucking gun. Best use of $10. God damn it is. Okay, I think I might end stream a little early. Because I am out of energy, I'll be honest. But... God... We will return Dialtown on Wednesday. Oh, fuck me. We will return on Dialtown on Wednesday. And... We'll see what happens if we don't use Bigfoot for evil and we instead use him for good. Oh my god, thank you, Sinna. God fucking damn. Well, either way, thank you everyone who joined. Good luck on continuing Dangan, Sinna, and Donut. And, I'm ready to hit the follow button. It's okay. All of you have a great rest of your day. I am going to relax now and try to make sense of what happened. It was a trip today. Finished off Jerry, went to hell, and then we got shot by Bigfoot. What a series of events. Okay, all of you have a great rest of your day. I'll see you Wednesday, same time. Bye. Oh, fuck.